So you got a new phone and you're wondering what settings you need to change first, right? So in this video, I'm gonna be showing you guys things that you need to change on your phone as soon as you get it. Hey, what's up guys, it's Banu here from AndroDollar.com. If you're new to my channel, definitely go ahead and smash that subscribe button right now and let's go ahead and explore them. Nowadays, the first thing that I do is I head into the settings and then go into system and find the system navigation and turn on the gesture-based navigation system. I really love using the gesture-based navigation system because it gives us more real estate on the screen to use, and in the future, everything is gonna be gesture-based, so it's better to be used to that now itself. The next thing that I do is I actually change these dock icons and put in things that I use more regularly, such as WhatsApp, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. So I actually get rid of messaging, Chrome, and camera, and have these instead of those. So let me quickly put in all of this to the dock, like that. So I have 5 icons in the dock usually on this device. So apart from that, I also make a folder with all the games that I don't use, and I really like to have the home screen organized. So I change the home screen settings as well, so you can find the home screen settings and then change the layout. I like to have the biggest layout size that is available, and then order it in a really nice way. I just get rid of all this stuff and install some good widgets and do all of that. So apart from that, I also go into the Play Store and install all the applications that I need. And I also go ahead and check and update all the apps. Next, usually I set up speed dialing on all of my devices. So for that, I go to the dialer and I just long press on any of the numbers and the speed dialing function will come up. And from here, you can assign any of the numbers that I want for speed dial. So if that doesn't come up, you can go to the settings of your calling app and enable it from there as well under speed dial. Next, I go into the settings and I usually search for power button ends call. This is a very important setting for me. No matter what device I use, I definitely have to have this setting turned on because I like to just press the power button and for the call to end. So if you are not using this, then I don't know why. So if by any chance this is something that you just discovered, drop a comment and let me know. Or if this is something that you also use on a regular basis, let me know by dropping a comment down below as well. The next thing that I do is I actually go into the notification area and I edit it the way I like. So mainly I have mobile data up here along with sound, Bluetooth, and then the flashlight. So I have all the other settings here as well, such as ultra power saving mode and do not disturb mode, which I regularly use. Other settings I don't really care about that much. And I also go into the settings and then I like to change some settings under the display, such as the sleep timer. So I usually change it to around 2 minutes. And in certain devices, I even change it to 10 minutes depending on how regularly I test the device. And I also enable the eye comfort mode and schedule it so that it automatically starts and ends. And if you really want, you can adjust the text size. I usually make it as small as possible. This is how I have so much detail crammed up in the screen. Some of you guys asked me that in my previous video as well. So this is how I do that. Screens these days are pretty big, so we should be able to put in a lot of information in it, so it's really easy to see everything at a glance. Along with that, I go into the sounds and then change up the ringing tone on any of my devices. I don't really like to use the default ringtones that come in, so I have my own custom ringtones that I use. And finally, I explore the device based on what device it is, and I see what other good settings are there for me to enable, if there are any fancy settings or if there are any new settings that I would like to test out so that I can make a video about it. And also based on what apps I install, I also go into the notifications and enable or disable notifications based on how many notifications keep popping up. Say for an example, if Facebook is bothering me too much, I go ahead and disable notifications from here, for an example. So just like that, you can manage your life as well if you want, and customize the device the way you want, because at the end of the day, you paid for this device, you are free to do whatever you want with it. And for my primary devices, I usually use a custom launcher as well, along with a bunch of other settings. If you guys are interested in seeing my full smartphone setup, let me know by dropping a comment down below, because I almost change my setup once a week. If you guys are interested in a video like that, I'll definitely make that happen for you guys as well. So I just thought of making this quick little video to show you guys my process when I set up a device. Let me know what you guys think. Drop a comment down below. You can find me on social media at Andro Dollar for all the behind the scenes and updates that are happening right here on Andro Dollar. And you can stay tuned to AndroDollar.com for all the latest from the tech world. If you guys haven't seen my coverage of the Huawei Nova 4 with the punch hole display, definitely go ahead and check that out. I'll have links down below in the description as well. And until I see you guys in my next video, this is Banu, signing out.